What's up guys, this is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure you hit that like and subscribe for more video content. In this video, I will be answering a question from one of my viewers. The question basically said, how do you add a raster band to an existing raster image? So I'll be illustrating that for you in this video. So let's get started. I brought in four images here, three, four, and I may need to zoom into them because I do not see them. All right, so as you can see, these four are in pieces, okay? And a lot of times when you bring in or you go out and you find some raster data, it'll come in pieces, and each piece is a mosaic little quarter of an image. And you can use them like this in your layers, or you can combine them into one consistent image. All right, so let's go ahead and let me show you how to add bands to a specific layer or add bands together. Let's go to Raster, Miscellaneous, Build Virtual Raster. Okay, we'll do that. And now in this dialog box, we are given several options. The first option is the input layers. What layers is this algorithm going to run on? The second option is the resolution. Will we do high, low, or average resolution? Okay, highest, lowest, or average. The next thing is the place each input file into a separate band, and we'll leave that checked for now. The other is allow projection difference. So each of these layers has its own CRS or its own projection. Do we want to allow those differences to remain in the final or in the product? So if we check this, if these were different, those differences would remain. The next thing is the advanced parameters here. All right, so we have an add alpha mask band to VRT or virtual raster image when source raster has none. So for these four, they already have their alpha mask. If you didn't though, you can check this and this algorithm will create one for you. The next thing, these next couple of options are optional, but I'll explain them anyway. So we have override projection for the output file. So if these did have different CRSs or projections, we could override all of their projections in the output file by placing it here. All right, and you'll just click this little button and find the CRS that you want. The next thing is the resampling algorithm. So if we pull this down, we have several resampling methods, but we will stick with the nearest neighbor. The other thing is the no data values for input bands, and you can just space them put a space in between each one that you want. The no data is a necessary part of a raster image. Okay, and you can actually manipulate the no data values with the raster calculator, which gives me an idea about another video. But anyway, let's go ahead and talk about this additional command line parameters. If you want to add any additional executions or calls into your algorithm, you can do that here. By default, the virtual layer that will be created will be a scratch layer, but you can actually save it directly into a permanent file with this option. So we'll go over here, we'll click this drop down, and we will save it to the file that we want. So this will open up our file explorer and allow us to name a location where we want this file saved, or choose a location where we want the file saved. okay? And then you have this open output file after running algorithm, which is checked, which means that it will open in your layers over here, okay? If you uncheck this, then it's not gonna open it. All right, let's go ahead and get into this. We will choose those four layers here. And the first thing that you may notice is that the CRS is beside the layer name. All right, so we're going to use the CRSs of, or the layers with the same CRS here. The thing about using a CRS that is different in these is that it will need to be reprojected, okay? Especially if you want it to be calculated in the same CRS. And you got to remember that when you reproject a layer, so like if we took this EPSG4326 and reprojected it into this layer, every time you reproject, it distorts the original values by a little bit, okay? So the more reprojection or warping that you do of a CRS, the more distortion you get. So it's always good to just work within the same reprojection if you can. All right, so now we have these selected. If you want to add a file that you don't see here, you can go over here to the add files and it'll open up your file explorer and you'll be able to choose the file that you want. If you want to do a folder, add directory, we can add a folder here. Also, we can toggle on and off whichever layer that we want. Toggle selection, clear selection. Well, I shouldn't have clicked that. Pick those four again, or we can select all. Now we'll go back, and everything looks good here, and we'll go ahead and we will run this. All right. So we have a new creation out here. Let me get rid of these old pieces. We have a new creation here. And as you can see, we have a green, red, blue, and black. Let's go into our properties here. You can either double click or you can right click and then select properties. So we have several things here. We have our information. These are in meters. We have our the distance covered, the extent. All right, so let's see, the source, virtual, we can see our CRS here. So let's do this symbology. Symbology is going to show you the color variation between the bands. Usually the minimum is 0 and the maximum is 255 unless it has been manipulated. Okay, and as you can see, these have some manipulation in here. But no matter what kind of rendering type that you have, when it looks like this, you're not going to be able to manipulate it well over here in this in these options. Now, before we go and fix this problem, let's look through here. We also have contrast enhancement. We have our min and maximum value settings. We have our blending mode, brightness, saturation, hue. We have the grayscale, the contrast, and we also have our resampling methods down here. But let's go and fix this coloring, because you don't want to be using this kind of stuff in a project. So let's go ahead and we can take that away. We'll go back to our raster, go to our miscellaneous build virtual raster. And now we will select those four again. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we can go back. And now this is the problem here. Place each input file into a separate band. We don't want that. We want them all in a single band. So let's go ahead and uncheck that. And we will run this. Alright, and it is going to work. Takes a little bit, but it's going to pop through. Okay, and so we have our virtual image here. And as you can see, now we have one complete virtual raster image. So when we take it away, it is all one single image now. Okay, So let's go and look in the properties now of this. Double click. Okay. And now in our properties, we can see 0 to 255, 0 to 255, 0 to 255. And you can see the coherent colors of... Why won't this move? Okay. You can see the coherent colors of this raster image. Okay, no more green, red, and blue. And let's open up these files here. And as you can see, they're coming in pieces. Okay, these are my next raster images. Okay, so let's go ahead and with this cropland, we're going to make a full raster image from these pieces, these six pieces here. Now remember, you do not have to use all of these for the pieces. If I just wanted to do like North America and Africa, all I would need to do is select North America and Africa and put those two in a raster, in a single raster image. But let's go ahead and do this. We'll go to raster, miscellaneous, build virtual raster. Okay, and right here we'll go ahead and pick our, this is Africa, Asia, Europe, North America, Oceanic or Australia, and South America. We'll go back, make sure that this option here is deselected, because if we don't, it's going to come out in six different colors. All right, so now we can run this. Okay, we can exit. And now if we, this is our virtual layer, let's go ahead and take these pieces down. And now we have a single image here, single image created from our raster data. Okay, all right, so let's go to the properties of this one. Of course, it's just black and white, you know, single band gray. Of course, the default will select based on the colors that are there, so you don't have to actually go and do it. It does it by default. All right, but I think that I answered the question there. Another thing, I will be putting these, the links to this raster data down in the description. With the croplands, you will need to sign up to get those raster data images. It is free, but you need to sign up to get those raster data images. But with the Jackson raster data, it's just no sign up. You can just go and download it. If those links ever change, please let me know in the comment section that those links have changed, and I'll see if I can find replacements for them. But thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.